I can't quote you club owners or television executives by name, but I know that the nature of what Bill did was not universally applauded and accepted because it did challenge the status quo and might upset certain political sensibilities in the audience and in the corporate structures.
When his stuff was taken off the air for Letterman, he wrote me a 32-page letter, handwritten, a sort of a creed occur. He couldn't understand the situation just because, you know, he was a free spirit. He was, the whole point of it was a joke. These jokes had import, but it was the prescribing of his freedom which so offended him.
Well, our relationship with Bill Hicks came to kind of a peculiar ending, made all the more peculiar by the man's death. And I have personal regrets about how our relationship developed prior to his death. So it makes me doubly sad that he's now not around so that we can, I think, correct mistakes that were made on his behalf. So I feel a personal sense of regret regarding that.
And what it did also do was give him a more material for his belief, correct in my view, that television worked to control the society, to keep the culture credulous, to keep it from thinking, to enchant it, literally, to spellbind it. And his job, as he saw it, was to break the spell.
Go back to bed, America. Your government has figured out how it all transpired. Go back to bed, America. Your government is in control again. Here's American Gladiators. Watch this. Shut up. Go back to bed, America. Here is American Gladiators. Here is 56 channels of it. Watch these pituary retards bang their fucking skulls together and congratulate you on living in the land of freedom. Here you go, America. You are free to do as we tell you. You are free to do as we tell you.